All right. I don't know how long this stream's gonna last. Probably not very long. We'll see. I'm gonna maybe try to link my Square Enix account one more time. Hello! That doesn't surprise me. I haven't ever tried mobile, but I don't imagine it being good. Twitch's app was kind of janky. Okay. Let's see. Oh, okay. Well, my Square Enix account is linked. Fix the window. Bam. Did I get any cool stuff? Nope. All right. I did not want to do that.
Information from refine.
Wanted to blow up more places. Let's see. This looks. Ooh, there it is.
Ready to construct prototype device. May counteract tank, but field test needed. Meet Theo at coordinates.
Before you accidentally ban yourself, let me figure out how to unban people. Yeah, I just figured that out the hard way.
Finders keepers.
Alright, I don't really know how to unban people. Let me Google that real quick. Oh, okay. That's interesting. That doesn't sound right. Oh, interesting. This is weird. Okay, well, I'll figure it out if it comes to it, but right now it's kind of weird. They have a weird. Oh, yes, the pool was exactly what I needed. Rico away! Me and our friends also did a an escape room today, which those are really fun. So I'm kind of winding down from that. Who did I piss off? Oh, okay. That's good, I guess.
What's happening out there? Respond immediately.
If you ever get a chance to participate in an escape room, I highly recommend it. It's good fun.
Who's next?
Yeah. Exactly.
Is anybody left out there? Have we lost him? Report!
If you can get a group of friends together and do one, I really recommend it. I love it. I've done two now, and it was just completely worth it. Ooh, that was close.
We are sending naval support to your location. Naval forces are inbound to provide additional support. Please be advised, we have naval forces on route to your location.
So many places to liberate. Montagna will be next.
It's fun. Let's do it again.
They're really fun. They're easy to describe, but they're hard to actually appreciate until you do one. Well, then. I really don't know. I have not the slightest idea, honestly. This is going to be interesting. I hope this works. Something tells me it won't work. But I'm gonna try, damn it. Oh. What is that? Oh, that's the airship. Wow. There's still a place here that I haven't managed to find. Which is weird, because I really looked. I'm actually curious about that. It says there's one there, but I can't really get it. Wait, what? Yep, done the oil rig, done that one, and then it says it's here, but I swear I checked there. If you do, let me know how you like it. I can't really guarantee that the ones near you are any good, but the ones we've been doing are really good fun. I've heard that it really depends on the company, so I would say look them up on TripAdvisor or some other website where people can review them. What the fuck? Yeah. Woo! So there's apparently five? There's one, two, okay. What the fuck? It says there's five, but there's... I'm confused.
Ready to swoop down and free some of your comrades? A nearby truck is transporting prisoners out of the
The bombings continue, and now sporadic riots flare up with little extra coaxing. People die and weep unblamed. President Dante scrambles to win back the favor of the people. Soon the option of martial law will glisten like a shining savior.
Get back to your posts.
You know, I gotta be honest, I don't know. There are, without a doubt, some areas of the country, and people in the country who are super religious. But I honestly don't know.
This is dispatch. Did we get
him? Ooh, that looks
what's
really
going on?
Crazy.
Report.
Most of the people that I am friends with and know of and everything, are either quietly religious, or agnostic or atheist or something along those lines. I know far fewer very religious people than I know otherwise. That was a very poor way to phrase that. But I think you understood. Okay, I'm confused about this. Well, that's... Give me just a second. That's strange. I will talk about that in just a second. Right now, this is confusing the shit out of me. Who I want to just get this region done with. Oh my god, I don't need an in-depth fucking article. Yes, please, tell me. What the fuck? I don't understand. Am I an idiot? Like, Vulture, Porto Tridente, and Guardia Maestrel. Vulture. Where's Guardia Maestrel? I'm going to talk about what you're talking about in just a second. This is just killing me right now. I'm sorry. North 40, 46. I'm there. I'm like, what the fuck?
This is dispatch, come in. Why is no one responding?
I'm so confused. What the fuck? But where is it? Am I an idiot? Like, I hope not. Oh my god, if that's it, I'm gonna be so sad. I was looking at it. I was not understanding that map correctly. Aha, okay. That weird base I was messing around with was very confusing.
Never had a chance.
Okay, so, about the religion thing. That statistic honestly wouldn't surprise me if it was true. With many people, religion is very important to them. Or maybe just important to them. I wouldn't say very, but... even though they may not regularly go to church or actually pray or anything like that, religion's still important to a lot of people. That feels good. Heavy metal liberated. So, I guess if you consider that statistic, it's probably true. It wouldn't surprise me if it was true. Okay, let me put it this way. I have to... If I'm going to the grocery store, the one I normally go to, I probably drive for roughly 3 miles. I pass 3 churches on the way. That I know of, anyway. 3 that I know of. So, that's a fun fact for you that might help you decide. One's, like, Baptist or something, another one's Catholic, and another one, I don't know. Part of the reason I've been going to that grocery store lately is because there's an excellent Pokemon route.
Dispatch, sending ground reinforcements to your
position. And the reason I know that the churches are there is because every single one of them is a Pokestop. So. I saw Ghastly on the radar a few days ago, but I couldn't manage to track it down. Partly because the radar is bugged, and also partly because I'm terrible. Oh my god, wait, so you're saying you didn't catch it?
Bring down the strike team.
Hey, Brittany. Oof. Holy shit. Fuck you. Oh, that's terrible. I'm sorry.
This is dispatch. Request received. Reinforcements en route.
Okay, I'm probably only going to be streaming for a little bit, so cool. Some of my coworkers have been watching my old stream recordings while at work, and it makes me feel sort of uncomfortable. Since I live next to a college campus, where all the college kids are going crazy, so there's lure modules on, like, everything. Even, like, late at night. I don't need no rebel troops. Yeah, seriously, like a college campus is definitely the place to be if you're trying to be a Pokemon master. With your rebel support. I am the rebellion. Some people just have nothing better to do with their life than mess up other people's lives, so... Even if they do, stuff like that never lasts long. They'll either get bored or end up getting caught. Yeah, I don't like them either. But the bigger their network is, the easier it is to find out more about them. Or at least find out how they're taking over the computers and the botnet. I wonder if that's because you're on mobile.
Is anybody left out there? Come in!
Did I just unlock the Hydra? Hello, welcome back. Oh my god. I'm going to save this man. My new goal in this game is to break this man out of wherever the hell he's being held. He may not see his mom's birthday today, but he will see the next one if I have anything to say about it. Oh, I'm done. Cool. But I want to liberate the world so that DiRavello knows fear when I come for him. This is awkward. I'm waiting for my jetpack to come back. Oh, don't dive bomb, Rika! Oh, that's gonna be sad. More grenades! Yeah! Splat. Did I unlock the Hydra? Oh, I think I did. Alright, I like the Predator. Gonna stick with that. I like these. Yes! I got the Hydra! I'm gonna call in a mech. Kusava rifle? Is that a real thing you're asking me? Like, I don't think so, is the answer.
Operator Rico Rodriguez, recognized.
Oh, change is good.
Yeah, I don't think so, is the answer. Oh, it's in-game. Yeah. I still don't think so.
Adjusting lumbar support to user preference.
Are you kidding me? Wait, there's other DLC than what I bought? Give me a moment. Oh, I thought I got, like, okay, so I got the main pack. I thought I got the, like, the whole pack. Alright, let's see. Oh my god, there is. Combat buggy. Wait, that's... Okay, you gave that to me. You gave that to me. The final argument sniper rifle. Your hoe of a roommate? Well, there's a sniper rifle. An explosive sniper rifle. Ooh. The Bloodhound RPG. Laser guided. Okay. That's cool. And then the... And the what else? What else is there? The other rifle. It's a scorpion. Oh my god. Okay. Really don't think I'm gonna pay $250 for a gun. Oh well. Timber! Wow, I need to get out of here.
Your force is en route to your position. Eliminate that target now.
Wow, this is a terrible place. Get out. Get out, get out, get out. Okay, there we go. Fuck you. Meow. Ooh. Oh no, what have I done? I'm so clumsy. Beep beep. I'm so clumsy. Is there anything in here? Nope. Oh, there's more fuel tanks. Die. Woo!
Sending additional ground forces to your location immediately.
Where's this other transformer? This way. Eject! Eject! There you are, bastards. Assuming those things are part of the next and last.
What is the situation? Respond.
Base go boom boom. Whoa!
Rebel activity reported. Get to the following coordinates immediately.
I'm not quite sure what you mean by that question.
Understood. We are providing additional manpower at this location.
What the fuck? Chill, y'all. Sam's. There you are, bitch. Okay. I don't personally mess around with sleeping and driving. Just because I have a very bad tendency to get sleepy when I'm driving. So I don't personally mess around with that. But 45 minutes isn't that bad, luckily.
Additional troops inbound. Locate the rebel immediately. Do not let him escape.
I'm dead. Oh. Yeah, it doesn't seem like you do, just since you're watching right now and it's past 5 there.
That would mean I sleep more, if that was the case for me.
So close. that's about when I start school. I start on the 17th. Studying human resources. Well, so the college I go to, they have a pretty general management degree for just like business management, and then you concentrate on a certain area, and I'm concentrating on human resources, which includes like staffing and hiring and compensation and all that stuff. So basically the people side of business. And just because I like the subjects, I'm also, getting a minor in psychology and a minor in philosophy. You.
Troops inbound. Target is at large. Re-establish secure contact immediately.
That's hot.
Studying is yes, it's very expensive. I don't necessarily know about compared to the rest of the world, but it is very expensive. Okay, that sounds like a solid choice. That's good.
Be advised that chopper support is approaching your location.
I don't know how expensive it is compared to other countries, but it is still very expensive. I got pretty lucky with scholarships and stuff, though, so it's not that bad for me. But it is bad for other people. I've always been very interested in video and picture editing, especially picture editing, personally, but I have never really tried to get good at it, or even really tried at all. If I remember correctly, I've heard about Norway before being like a shining example of how an education system should be. I don't remember the details, but I remember what I think of Norway. I think like, man, I should have gone there to go to college. That sort of thing. because of the way things have worked out for me, I actually do too. But that is not the case for most people. Which is what I meant by I'm very lucky. Yeah, it's pretty bad, honestly. Which is actually a big reason why Bernie Sanders was doing so well, because he was appealing to the many people here who have a very large education debt, or who know that one is coming. Come on! Oh, does that not? Oh, that's bullshit. That's bullshit. That's bullshit. It should have at least let me count what I had already dropped in. I'm actually kind of worried about an education bubble in the U.S., if that makes sense. I'm worried that in the coming years there's going to be very many people with degrees, and that the value of a degree is going to kind of decrease, essentially. And I'm worried it'll be kind of a repeat of our housing bubble thing, where no one could pay their debt and it exploded and the housing market just collapsed. I'm worried it's going to be that, but for the education system. And for some reason or another, our country doesn't really seem to value laborers anymore. Like, for an example, if someone says they're a plumber, for some reason that has generally a negative, view, but I mean, like, shit, like, plumbers need to exist, like, just because they didn't have to go to school for who knows how long to become a plumber doesn't mean we don't need plumbers. So yeah, there's my little rant for the day. I mean, like, we need garbage men to like drive around and pick up trash, and for some reason people act like that's just this shitty job that should be frowned upon and everything, but like, it needs to be done, and just because they didn't have to go to college to do that doesn't mean like they're a terrible person or that they should feel bad about doing a necessary job. And a very large amount of people in most industries don't have a degree that matches their industry. Like, yes, they have a degree, but it doesn't match their industry at all. My manager, who, like, manages this
entire, like, 900 person property, has a degree in musical theater. So, like, that's kind of an example of what I was talking about. Picking up garbage here has a very mediocre salary at best, and it comes with the whole social impact of you touch people's garbage. Real strange thing. Yeah, I agree. Like that's I view it as a shitty job. Not in the sense that like the people that do it are shitty. I mean, I don't want to do it. I would not like to do it. So I think the people that are willing to do it should be compensated well. I don't really give a shit if they didn't have to go to college to learn how to load the trash cans. The point is, they've got to wake up every day knowing that they've got to deal with other people's garbage. And, like, that should be paid well, in my opinion. I am the Bavarium. I have become the Bavarium. I imagine so. I've got some interesting stories, just from like the 2 weeks every year I spend cleaning these apartments. So, like, I can't imagine. I bet they're good stories. Don't crash on me. Okay, thank you. Want to tell him, or do you want me to tell him? Oh, you asshole. You filthy, dirty asshole. I hate you. You have ruined this challenge for me. You fucking dick. I might stop this car and get out and kill that man. I had this challenge done. I had won. Okay, you can start. I don't really know if mine are good stories, because they might be the kind of story that you have to be there to appreciate. I hope that's not the case, but we'll see. Perfect. Fuck you. Oh my god, that's terrible. Like, how do you even have enough to fill a trash can? Oh god, no.
I didn't see that those were stairs. I'm just gonna stop flying for now. Oh my god, I would have thrown up. Oh my god, I would have thrown up so bad. Oh, that's so sad. Do you mean like cats that people put in there, or cats that like get in? Probably both, actually. What? I don't understand. Like, what? What do you mean? Like, when they're moving, they're like, okay, well, we can't bring our cat in the trash can that goes. Oh my gosh, that's fucked up. That's really fucked up. Shit. No, I wanted to retry. That's so terrible. Jeez. Okay. So, all of this happened last year. I wish there was a good way for me to, like, a very quick way for me to take pictures and upload them, but I don't think I have a good one. Okay, so there are, like, every apartment, basically. We have to first inspect it to kind of determine how it's gonna be, like, what, like, you know, like what we're getting ourselves into, and it's just, it's not an official rating system. We don't rate them like 5 stars or anything like that. We just kind of, we write in colorful language how bad it is, then we get everything together. And we decide what needs to happen to what apartment in what order. And we try to stagger them so, for example, paint teams can stay busy, but also not have to do every single room at once. That sort of thing. So the first part, in an ideal situation, the residents have left it somewhat clean, like at least reasonable. And we send in maintenance, and maintenance team fixes everything. They don't give a shit about making a mess.
They don't give a shit about the mess that's in there. If the door is broken, they'll put in a new door. If they scratch the wall while doing so, that's okay, because we're going to paint later anyway. So then there's maintenance, and then we get the paint team in, then we clean the carpets. I'm a failure. Wow, that sucked. And then we eventually go through and do like one final clean sweep where we like get all the dust, polish things, wipe it down, fix any dents and scratches, all that stuff. But if the apartment was not left in good condition, there's a step that comes before that called trashing. It's called trashing because there's trash. And that's reserved for the rooms that are seriously so full of shit that the maintenance team can't even get in there to properly fix things. So then they send some of us in with a gigantic bin and trash bags and gloves and not gas masks, but like doctor's masks. And we just get everything out. At that point, we don't worry about stains or anything, because that comes with the carpet cleaning later. We worry about, like, holy shit, there's a fucking potato that's looks like it's growing mutations. We should get that out of here. Like, that sort of thing. And on the down low, like, unofficially, we can keep the things that we find. Because the people have already relinquished the apartment in the state it's in, and they have acknowledged that they're not coming back, and that they've given up rights to everything in there. I found once a watch, like a very nice watch, that I now wear every day. I looked it up, I looked it up, and the watch is worth about $550. New, anyway. New. It's worth that. So it's a pretty nice watch, and I got it for free. One of my coworkers got a 60-inch TV once. People basically get just about everything you can imagine from them. Because people leave behind an unbelievable amount of stuff. But most apartments are just dirty and don't actually have anything cool in them. So there's one apartment that we had to... I wasn't actually part of this one. I just heard about it from my coworkers. I was doing other stuff. So apparently, the girl had renewed to live with us the next year. But she didn't fully understand how the renewal process worked. Including those. She didn't fully understand how the renewal process worked. So, even though she was transferring apartments, she just left. And went home to, I believe her home is China. And just was not going to come back for months. So she asked us to move her stuff for her. Legally, we could have said, fuck you, we're throwing your old shit away, buy new shit when you get here. But we didn't. We decided to be nice. So we moved her stuff for her. It was not that messy of an apartment. Also, not that clean. But really not terrible. And as my coworkers are going through this sweet, quiet little girl's... and by little girl, I just mean physically tiny. She's like 20 or something like that, just to be clear. As they're going through her dresser to move her clothes to her new apartment,
They find anal lube, a butt plug, and a ball gag. Just sitting in her bottom drawer. And since her apartment was clean, they had not really been using gloves. Which means, who knows, what exactly they had touched while they had been in there. They did not touch those things without gloves, but still, kind of makes you wonder what happened in that room, before that. Okay, so I have a very strong stomach. I don't... Smells don't really bother me that much. I can see things. I can see nasty things and not really get disturbed. It's just really hard to kind of make me queasy. So we were going through this one apartment. People had just left, and it smelled kind of bad. Not awful, but kind of bad. Most people were wearing their masks. I was not, because it made my face hot, and I didn't like that. And I accidentally knocked something off the top of the refrigerator. That something was a bottle of soy sauce that had sat on top of the refrigerator in this 85 degree apartment, because they like to keep it warm, for long enough for the soy sauce to expire by several months. Before I fully realized what was happening, the bottle hit the ground, literally exploded, and sent this just awful, rotten soy sauce splattering everywhere. None got on anyone, but the smell hit me, the smell hit me like a brick to the face. And for the first and only time we had been cleaning apartments, I almost threw up. Just because I didn't have the chance to mentally prepare myself. I was completely caught off guard. One minute I was just cleaning pots and pans, and the next minute there is this explosion of just like liquid brown death. And I almost threw up. Everyone else heard me gagging, so they came to look and they started gagging, and there were, I think, four of us in that room just trying to not throw up all over each other. So that was, luckily no one threw up, so that was nice. Maxie, wait, where's the, I unlocked a, what? There it is. Okay, so we had two very bad apartments. I believe on the inspection, on one of them, someone just wrote Jesus Christ. And I think on the other one, someone just wrote something like, Dear God, please help. So we knew it was going to be bad going in. It was bad. Nothing like too terrible. When it came down to it, we got everything decently clean, and it was looking pretty good. And then someone opened the dishwasher, and the dishwasher was green on the inside, slightly fuzzy, had some liquid in it that did not, it looked like a strange green-brown color. And all the dishes inside had something growing on them. And once again, just about everyone that was in there cleaning, almost threw up on each other. And with that dishwasher in particular, we decided to just throw it away. With most things, we try to reclaim them in some sense. Even if it's like replace a few parts and get it working again or whatever. But with this one, we just literally didn't clean it or anything. We closed it, sealed it so it wouldn't leak, and carried it outside and threw it in the dumpster. Like, we just completely gave up all hope of that dishwasher ever being used again. I understand why you would say that. We tried. Whatever was in it had clogged it. Well, whatever stuff had grown in the dishwasher had grown enough to clog the dishwasher. So turning it on and letting it clean itself was unfortunately not an option. I'm not sure what buffering's like, but if you need me to repeat something, just let me know. Okay, so do you need me to repeat stuff when it buffers, or do you just get behind when it buffers? How does that work? Okay, so what was the last part you heard about the dishwasher? Okay, so we did turn it on, and it ends up that whatever was growing in it had grown enough to clog the dishwasher. So we decided to call it quits, sealed it up, and threw it away. So yeah, we did try turning it on, but it was unfortunately beyond saving. Oof! I don't think we've found anything illegal as long as I've worked here, but policy is that we do report those.
large. Re-establish visual contact immediately. Be advised, tanks dispatched.
Oh, we do find illegal things during the year, though. And we let the police deal with that.
Copy that.
They simply report it and move on.
More units, find the rebel. Pursue aggressively.
Okay, first of all, I don't blame you, because if I had a taser, I would probably do the same thing. Okay, so I'm gonna finish talking, and then I've got a question for you. Yes, we have actually found both of those. At different points. Why do you have a taser? And why was a taser the best thing to kill a spider with? What do you mean what? Okay, but still, why do you have a taser? Okay, I'm honestly not supposed to say anything, but it's not as dramatic as you'd think, honestly. But I really am not supposed to say anything. No, it was not. It was not. I can say that. It was not. Holy shit, so many challenges.
One by one, they all fall before me.
Welcome back, Brittany. I'm sorry, but I am going to go for the night. I hope everything's okay with your roommate. Listen to this recording and then go.
General had to completely shut down Cava Montana. The legal details are, of course,
hostile contact. All units converge on these coordinates. ASAP.
Yeah. Yes, they told me. It's all just controlled demolition, very above board, and absolutely part of the master plan to improve this great country of ours, okay? Viva Medici.
I'll save you soon, Mr. Radio Man. Alright, I will talk to both of y'all later. Have a good night, and thank you for watching.